Hi, I'm Chris Edwards with Tennis Warehouse, and I'm here at the BNP Paribas Open 2017 with Dr. Malcolm Conway. Now, you've been here working with Bethanie Mattek-Sands a little bit and some of the other athletes in these 2 weeks. Can you kind of tell us how you got your start in tennis, bringing your skills to the tennis community?
Well, I have a practice at home in Pennsylvania, and we do a lot of sports injuries. And over the years, with various athletes, we get referrals. And at that time, I was working a lot with the NFL. And one of the guys was down in Florida and met Bethanie, and she was hurt at the time. And he said, hey, why don't you go see my guy in Pennsylvania? She came up, we had the relationship, and that's been going on now for years.
Great, and you're gonna take us through a couple of exercises today to try and help prevent some common injuries, right?
Absolutely, yes.
Awesome, all right, let's get into that. The first exercise we're gonna go through is one for the forearms and tennis elbow. You wanna take us through that, Dr. Conway?
Sure. Tennis elbow is normally called lateral epicondylitis. And it's usually a problem that starts out here with a lot of people with mechanical issues, not getting through the ball, either late or too early. And so it puts a lot of pressure on tendons here. There's one area you can do at home, very simple, is grab a towel. You're gonna place your hands just like this, sort of like you're riding a motorcycle. With your right hand, you're going to turn the gas on, and on the left one, you're gonna turn the gas off. And go as far as you can. At the same time, here's the key, pull the towel apart like this. And hold that for 20 to 30 seconds, and then you can repeat. If you do that 3 to 5 times, a couple times a day, you'll actually start feeling this pain slowly dissipate. And over a week or so, you'll see that thing pretty much go away. So we're gonna show you something here for your lower back, because a lot of patients in tennis complain to me after weeks and weeks, their low back starts tightening up, weakening, and then they notice they can't get into their positions properly. So what happens is, a lot of people get damage to their lower discs of their little cartridges at the in between your spines. So what you have to think about is that little disc is like a jelly donut. And that jelly donut moves like this. And when that jelly gets pushed back to the back end of it, it can cause pressure on the back side, which is where the spinal cord and nerves are. And that can cause inflammation and causes pain. So we're going to show you a really easy trick that you can do at home and knock that right out.
All right, let's get to it.
So he's gonna be laying down on his stomach, and he's gonna be in a push-up position with his arms just a little bit wider than his armpits here. He's going to keep his belly button or belt buckle on the ground at all times, and he's gonna push his upper body up as far as he can, but his belt buckle has to stay down, and you want this arch to come up as far as you can, hold it, and back down. You basically come on up again. You want to really pinch the lower back as basically as hard as you can. Hold it and back down. And by doing that through 10 repetitions, you'll see a tremendous relief after you do these segments every day. But as you do one or two, it may pinch a little bit. Don't worry about it, get pinched right through it. And then eventually you'll see it gets easier and easier.
Next one we're going to work on is something I know I really need to work on, and that's shoulders.
Yeah. Well, shoulders break down a lot. Obviously, in tennis, that's what you're using every day. So one of the reasons that shoulders start fatiguing is not because of the big muscles, it's because of the smaller muscles. And it's mainly because of the scapular stabilizers. These are little muscles in the back that don't tend to turn on because the over muscles begin to overpower them. So we're going to give you a very simple little exercise you can do every day at home, and you'll see a major change in a couple days or weeks. Put your arms up. You got to put everything, both arms up on the wall like this, completely flat. Elbow, wrist, and fingertips will be completely flat. We're gonna imagine where I'm tapping is 12 o'clock, and he's gonna take both arms up to 12 o'clock, keeping everything flat, elbow, wrist, and fingertips. So he has a bit of a weakness here in both scapula, and he can feel not only the restriction of his arms going up, but he can also feel some discomfort going up. Don't be afraid of the discomfort because you're not going to break anything. But by doing this, as time goes on, you will see amazing changes in the back. And the strength will come along too, and your tennis will get probably much better.
Well, just doing those few exercises, I've already worked up a little bit of a sweat. We're out here in the heat where hydration is really important. So Dr. Conway, you want to talk a little bit about some hydration?
Sure. One little trick you can do at home is get a little Himalayan salt or pink. They call pink salt or Himalayan salt. You put a dime's worth in your palm of your hand, you throw it in, and then drink. It has 82 to 85 electrolytes in it, that are elements that are natural to the body, as opposed to table salt, which is stripped of everything. There's really just sodium chloride in it, nothing else. The Himalayan salt is more natural to your body. It actually helps with the cells. It helps the fluid transport. It actually, with some people, takes their blood pressure and normalizes it. It's an unbelievable thing. But sweating, because if you're going to drink a lot of water, you're going to excrete a lot of water, and that pulls stuff out of you, minerals, electrolytes. You want to keep that in, and once in the morning or once at night, you can do it once and it's over.
All right. All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us today and showing us some great exercises to really help tennis players out.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot.